Hi guys, what's up? This is Tafik here and welcome to another great video. This video is the first devlog for our upcoming multiplayer VR shooter title codenamed Project Immortal. And this game will be our first official VR title. In this video, first I will shortly introduce the game and then I will show how we decided on the game engine based on the features and mechanics of the game. So, let's get started. Well, currently this game is in the design stage and we are an indie team with 3 people, including me. If you don't know me, this is Tafik here. I am an XR developer and online instructor with over 20,000 students around the world. For the past 2 years, I've been teaching XR game development on Udemy. And last year, I found my own company, Iron Hat, to help grow the VR community by publishing online courses, assets, and of course, VR games. Speaking of VR games, Project Immortal will be our first game title. That is why we are very excited about it. Project Immortal is a story-driven multiplayer VR shooter game with a unique VR shooting mechanic. And the story will be very short for the early access version. Right now, I cannot share much about the game mechanics or the main story, but I can tell you that there will be a simple yet unique VR shooting mechanic that the game will be built upon. And we will have the multiplayer modes such as Deathmatch and Team Deathmatch. We will publish the alpha version on SideQuest this summer. And at the end of this summer, we will be publishing the beta version on AppLab and SteamVR. By now, you must be wondering which game engine we will use to develop such a game. Well, I am glad that you asked this. But before I tell you my answer to this, I want to ask you the same question. Which game engine should I choose to develop a story-driven multiplayer VR shooter game? Okay, that's a very hard question to answer, especially if you know only the genre of the game. As a hint, as you guess, it will be Unity or Unreal Engine. But even then, that is hard to choose. Then let me give you more detail on the game and explain to you which game engine is better at particular feature according to my opinion. It may look like a cliche Unity Unreal comparison, but this time I just need some help to clarify my decision. Before I start, assume that you do not know neither of these engines or you know both the game engines. Because most of the time, game developers think that the game engine they know is the best game engine. But I think that is not true. So just try to be objective on this. Okay, firstly, I want Project Immortal to look real. I mean, I want to have a realistic environment with realistic characters and weapons. The reason for this is simple. I just like it in that way. I played lots of VR games and I still play on daily basis. And the game that I've been playing most is Pavlov VR. I can tell you that I adore this game's graphics. Shooting mechanics are also awesome, but the realistic approach in this game helped me to immerse more in VR. I mean, for example, if the game has cartoon style art, I do not like those kind of games in VR, even if it is a funny game. And of course, it is my opinion. You are always welcome to write your opinion on this in the comments. So, based on this criteria, Unreal Engine gets a point. Because Pavlov VR is made using Unreal Engine 4, and it is no doubt that Unreal Engine does a great job with realistic games out of box. Of course, I know that Unity does that too with its recent rendering pipelines, but my point goes to Unreal for that. Okay, the second important detail on Project Immortal game is that we must use a full body VR system instead of floating hands. And there are 2 reasons for this. The one is that we need the full body VR feature for the unique VR shooting mechanic in our game. And the second reason is that with full body VR, we have more immersed VR experience than with floating hands. However, full body VR systems need to have body trackers in order to work best. But with inverse kinematic, we can have a basic full body VR system based on headset and controller's tracking data. Although not perfect, both Unity and Unreal Engine offer inverse kinematic systems for full body VR. In Unity, the best option for this is to use an external asset called FinalIK on Unity Asset Store. FinalIK is really working well, and I already used it in my multiplayer VR template asset and Quidditch VR game YouTube tutorials. But it is a bit expensive. On Unreal Engine side, we have PowerIK, a full body IK solver offered as free by Epic Games. Truth be told, I did not try it yet for full body VR, but it seems promising. And since it is free, I have the option to open source my game to grow the community later on. So based on full body VR feature, Unreal Engine gets another point from me. But of course, I need to test PowerIK to make the final decision for this feature. Okay, we have one more important feature left to decide to game engine for Project Immortal development. And that feature is to have characters. Lots of characters. Our main game mechanic requires to have many different humanoid characters with unique looking. Besides, it will be a multiplayer VR game, so it will be nice to have a VR avatar system that players can create and customize their own virtual avatars. This, of course, requires designing many unique avatars and import into the game engine. Character Creator 3 and Dust 3 can be used for such a feature. Or we can go for a solution within the game engine to design and create a VR avatar system. In Unity, there is a third-party asset called UMA 2 Unity Multipurpose Avatar. It is basically a system to create customizable avatars with code. I already used this asset in my multiplayer VR template assets VR avatar system. And for a non-designer like me, it is really great. So we have a solution for characters in Unity. Great! On the Unreal Engine side, we have an amazing solution, which is MetaHumans from Epic Games. It is a new tool to create very realistic characters in a very short time and effort. And MetaHuman Creator is the perfect tool for our multiplayer VR shooter game, so-called Project Immortal. It is still in early access, but it will be soon open to everyone. So, for this criteria, Unreal Engine gets another point because MetaHumans look really awesome and Epic Games officially supports it. Alright, that was all the detail I can give right now about Project Immortal. In total, it seems that Unreal Engine is a better option than Unity based on what we need. Let me point out that I have almost 3 years of experience in Unity and I am learning Unreal Engine only for the past 2 months. But since I have Unity experience, I learn Unreal Engine quicker. So the final decision is to first learn Unreal Engine enough to test the features in the game or at least make a prototype. And in the meantime, we will design the game and finalize the story, mechanics, and features. According to that, we will make the final decision on using Unity or Unreal Engine. But I can say that Unreal Engine has a better score. In this video, I wanted to announce that I've been working on my first game title codenamed Project Immortal. And I wanted to share the process of planning to publish a full game. Let me know in the comments what you think of Unity and Unreal Engine in terms of the features we want to have in our game. I really need your help on this because I am still learning Unreal Engine. And maybe you have experience with both engines and you think that going with the engine that I already know is a better option. Also, let me know in the comments that what you'd like to see in the next devlog. Thanks a lot for watching and I will see you in the next video.